Hey guys, have here a little project for you called AquaPazza. Righteously, I've been trying to get to this game for a while, but I got it like right before Injustice came out, and I've like literally just been busy playing the hell out of Injustice. Green Arrow, Batgirl, yes. And well, it's about time I finally give this game at least time to shine. At least some time to shine. Now, if you're an Arcana fan, this game is pretty much feels similar to you, like all other XMU games. And well, I'm gonna just give like a short tutorial breakdown of how the game is really. Let's go to training. Now, basically. This game, you pick a character and you pick an assist. Similar like how you have like Marvel 1 assist. Other than your assist is like after, but you have each assist has like a different cooldown time till you use them. And well, let's just go over the characters right here. Konami here is your Ryu of the game. Or for some of you Arcana players, your heart of the game. Has your standards. Well, she has like Rekka-based moves. She has a Shoryuken. She has Rekka-based moves and Shoryuken, and well, she's more friendly toward easier characters. Toward beginners. Otherwise, this guy also like a Ryu, but in this case, Guilty Gear fans, it's kind of similar to like a Kai feel with the sword play with him. Well, Arwen. Just by design, he's like cool in general. Then for all you Zangief fans, your grappler of the game, right here, Tamaki. Let's just say this chick will deal way more damage than Zangief would ever wish to deal in a game. Oh yes. And then you have, right here, Rayon. Basically, she's like your mid-screen keep-away character. Well, a decent mid-screen keep-away character, and it's like, just treat her like a Dawson. That's all I have to say. Toka here. Okay, matched her with the right assist. Rena, god, like assist. She could be a rushdown monster. You can't get her off you at one point. Manaka. Basically, she chucks books at you. She's kind of keep away and has like unique tools of dodging, but what else can I say about this chick? Basically, you win with her, you can literally tell your opponent to learn, motherfucker, learn. It's one of my favorites and one of my mains in this game, Morgan. Okay. Basically, Morgan, she has like a mix-up style, and plus, well, what makes her unique, her arrow counter. In each round of a match, she gets 20 arrows. Once you use those arrows up, you basically have no projectile game at that point. But as fast as matches go in this game, 20 is more than enough. And this chick, let's just say, you want easy damage? That's all I gotta say about this. Then for all you people that love defensive characters, Sasarai, defensive monster. It could be quite hard to crack her up, but even though she has like an air dash, her mobility is a bit slow. But in the right hands, you will never crack her up, really. Chizuru, let me just tell you this. Top tier. One, it's like zero. You can't block this chick. She's like zero with the damage. You can't block this chick. She has mix-ups. Even blocking her mix-ups has more mix-ups on top of mix-ups. It just... Oh god. Oboro. Well, yeah, he do it well. That's all I can say about him. Then the multi. Well, multi, basically, consider it like this. All you Tatsunoko versus Capcom fans, consider her role with the Tatsu. Literally, role with the Tatsu. But not it. That's most setting. Oh, yeah. And this guy, well, basically, just think of Captain Commando. You fight with assists. In his case, it's a big-ass whoop that comes out of nowhere either side of the screen. Yeah, but since this is just starting off, let's go and deal with Konami. What do I feel like getting up to see? And like I said, you get to select your partner. These assists, each work in a different way. Yuma, she will run your ass over with the bike. And it's like good for combo extensions if once you get the timing right. Octavia, also as well good combo extensions, but her timing is a bit weird at times. Camu, basically, she can keep you from, other than extending combos, she can literally keep you from jumping, and you could get pinned down with her real easy. Myron. Well, basically, she dive kicks and she shoots fireworks. While in her boss form, she traps you in the ground and you can extend a combo and still dive kicks your ass. I really don't remember what she does. I remember one of her assists. She keeps you locked down and that's about it. Othermi. Basically, she's like literally the same as Camu assist-wise. Sakari, basically, her assist takes a while to come out, but once it does, it traps the opponent in place, and you can basically follow up with whatever you like. Lyra, combo extender on the counter. Her assist is a bit slow, a bit. Mizuki, godlike uppercut. Runs from out of fucking nowhere. Yuki, basically what her assist is, she sings, you can cancel your air normals off of really any ground normal that leaves you airborne. And well, you have snowflakes falling, making it hazardous to your opponent's movement. Sasuke, literally one of the best assists in the game. Just because her, basically, she's your get-in assist, as in she shoots. It forces you to get in and get all in your opponent's face. And for a character like Konami, who I just picked, who wants to like be in there, this is like an excellent choice for you. You, basically, she slaps you with a fan. That's all I have to say on that. Reno, who I seriously think is a top-tier assist, depending on who you pair her with. Basically, just imagine Yang's Genijin plus Yang's freaking copy super. That's basically what she does. But since her assist is like really that good, she takes like the longest to come out. But anyway, let's just start with Sayuki. Just because it's like, get in there. Colors. Random you. Sure, why not playground? Yeah, let's see. This game is like literally a 4-button fighter. You have your lights, your mediums, and your heavies. Wow. And then your fourth button, which is your assist button. Demonstrate. That really. Well, then a core heavy. then, like every other game, you have supers. Okay, now what makes the chain system in this game unique? Most characters, you can only combo into a special, like after light medium. On the kind of most of the characters trying to combo off a heavy will not work at all. Oh yeah, I forgot I had the motion meter on. Oh yeah. Best part about the game, you can switch any character. You can switch characters. That's what I meant to do. You can switch characters on the fly, and you can switch characters on the fly in training, depending on if you want to switch it up. Okay, now something that makes this game kind of unique is the emotion meter, like what just happened right there. Basically, how it works is if you're in emotion high. I'll try to get it. Okay. Basically, when you're in emotion high, which you literally get by just keep attacking and forcing your opponent to block a lot. Basically, yeah, when you keep attacking and force your opponent to block a lot. You deal way more damage than you see, like right there. You deal way more damage, and it shows. And well, yes, more damage, we love it, and it makes you more of a threat, which this game literally promotes you to keep attacking like non-stop. Because while you're in emotion low, you take less damage. While you're in emotion low, you take more damage. And plus, your attacks are not as strong. So, yes, this game encourages you to be extremely offensive. A lot. Yes, exactly. Yeah, anyway. Also, what's unique about this game is it will tell you a basic combo with a character, and it has one for each assist in the game. The fact they went out and did this with like every character and every assist, I kind of like it. Like, watch. Basic combo. And that's like a basic combo with her. Now this one shows what you can do with this assist, and since I picked Rin, you just see basically how to extend combos. Trust me, I'm not like trying nothing right now, because I haven't played this game enough yet to get execution heavy. Oh yeah, supers. Yeah.